Money is a motivator for some big changes that are inching a little closer to reality here in Illinois.
Yeah, politicians in Springfield are debating everything from new casinos to a new tax structure. WGN political reporter Tavon Bradley joins us now with how it's playing out.
Ben and Lourdes, to generate revenue, Governor Pritzker is proposing legalizing recreational marijuana, sports betting, and a graduated income tax. Today, new details about the push to pass two of those measures.
State lawmakers have exactly 4 weeks to sort out differences over gambling expansion and the graduated tax constitutional amendment. A sports betting bill is expected soon, and Governor Pritzker is counting on it passing. His budget for the next fiscal year includes $200 million in new state revenue from sports betting licenses. Democrats and Republicans say the General Assembly is close to an agreement on sports betting, but a Chicago casino is a different story. Mayor-elect Lori Lightfoot and Mayor Rahm Emanuel support one.
The city of Chicago supports sports wagering and the legalization of it within a comprehensive amendment that provides for a publicly owned Chicago casino license.
But other cities and municipalities want in.
A Rockford casino would provide good-paying union construction jobs and hundreds of permanent jobs.
This is not new. In the past, regional differences have slowed attempts to expand gaming in Illinois. Governor Pritzker says he doesn't want regional disputes to upend the process. Today, when asked if he backs a Chicago casino, Pritzker said this.
What I'm most focused on is making sure that we maximize the opportunity to balance our budget, and that's why I focused on sports betting.
Republican State Senator Jason Barrickman told WGN News there could be GOP votes. Historically, gaming has received bipartisan support. I do believe that's possible this year, but it would have to be comprehensive, he said. On taxes, the House is set to take up a constitutional amendment moving the state to a graduated income tax. The Senate passed the measure this week, along with the proposed tax increases that would go into effect only if voters approve the constitutional change.
I'm excited that it's going to the House now, and I'm very confident about our ability to get it through the House.
Barrickman and his Republican Senate colleagues voted against the amendment. He told us, "Our concern is it makes it easier to pass tax increases in the future."
To sway Republicans, Democrats passed a property tax freeze in the Senate, but the constitutional amendment would have to be ratified and the state would need to boost funding for schools. Republicans call the Democratic proposal a political stunt, Ben and Lourdes.
So nothing for certain.
Just yet. Nothing for certain. Republicans want some property tax relief right now rather than this particular proposal, and we'll see. They've got 4 weeks.
Okay. Thanks, Tamon.